Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Vamsikiran. My paper presentation topic is evaluation of mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes by MDCT in benign and malignant etiologies and correlation with histopathology. Co-authors are Dr. Panil Kumar sir and Dr. Pradeep Kumar sir from Shantaram Medical College and General Hospital and Nandyal. Introduction, CT is an important diagnostic tool for evaluating many clinical conditions. MDCT is a technology that has provided faster data acquisition and allow three-dimensional multiplanar reformations and minimum intensity projections, projection algorithms and volume rendered imaging. This has resulted in highly refined detailed imaging. Image in case of imaging of thorax, MDCT gives valuable information regarding the site, size, shape, margins, attenuation, calcification, necrosis, and characterization of mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes, the ability to differentiate between benign and malignant lymph nodes, early detection of enlarged mediastinal, malignant mediastinal lymph nodes helps clinicians to decide further diagnostic steps and narrow down the treatment protocol. Mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes are enlarged in wide range of pathologies. The spectrum of conditions include benign granulomatous disorders like TB, sarcoidosis, and malignant conditions like lymphoma and metastatic carcinoma. Rare causes include lymphoproliferative disorders, Castleman disease, primary hypogammaglobulinemias, and histoplasmosis. Since the advent of MDCT, there has been a decline in the use of other conventional diagnostic procedures like fluoroscopy and arteriography. MDCT demonstrates a precise and accurate delineation of all mediastinal structures. Therefore, it is a modality of choice for most mediastinal lesions and associated lymph node enlargement. As MDCT is easily available and mostly in most of the secondary and tertiary care centers, it is accessible for the general population. Our study aims to evaluate mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes in benign and malignant etiologies by MDCT and correlate the findings with the histopathology. Aims and objectives of the study to determine the efficacy of MDCT in characterization of the mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes as benign or malignant, to correlate MDCT findings of benign and malignant lymph nodes with histopathology. Typical lymph node characteristics on CT, they are discrete and surrounded by mediastinal fat. They are round, elliptical or triangular in shape, soft tissue attenuation. The short axis or least diameter of the lymph nodes are used when measuring the size. Based on intrathoracic lymph node metastasis from extrathoracic neoplasm study, short axis measurement of 12 mm in upper is the upper limit of normal for subcarinal lymph nodes and 10 mm for lower paratracheal and tracheobronchial lymph nodes and 8 mm for rest of the lymph node groups. Diagnosis of the lymph node abnormality is based on lymph node enlargement, lymph node morphology, lymph node attenuation, and lymph node enhancement. Coming to the lymph node enlargement pattern, the nodes having short axis of less than 2 cm reflect a variety of non-infectious and non-granulomatous inflammatory diseases, whereas metastasis and lymphoma granulomatous diseases, these are usually greater than 2 cm in size. Coming to the lymph node morphology, coalescence of lymph node enlarged lymph nodes we seen in neoplasms and granulomatous infections. Discrete enlarged lymph nodes associated with almost all cases of mediastinal lymph node enlargement. Diffuse mediastinal enlargement it is difficult to diagnose unless the attenuation of the mediastinal soft tissue is compared with the attenuation of the fat on the same scan. Usually seen in undifferentiated carcinoma, lymphoma, granulomatous mediastinitis, or generalized infection. Coming to the lymph node attenuation, low density necrotic lymph nodes commonly seen in metastasis, seminoma, lymphoma, tuberculosis, fungal infections. Enhancing lymph nodes seen in metastasis and Castleman diseases. Calcified lymph nodes commonly seen in tuberculosis, infectious granulomatosis, sarcoidosis, and fungal infections, silicosis, Hodgkin lymphomas. Material method of size. All study population is all patients referred to radiology department, Shantaram Hospital, for radiography and CT with clinical suspicion of lung and mediastinal pathologies. Method of collection of data. It is an analytical study conducted on 50 patients who came to department of radiology, Shantaram Hospital, with clinical suspicion of lung and mediastinal pathology for a period of 1 year, from September 2020 to August 2021. Equipment used is 128 slice MDCT scanner, Siemens and Somatom. Inclusion criteria, patients with clinical suspicion of lung and mediastinal pathologies, patients consenting to both CT and biopsy of mediastinal primary lesion or lymph node. Exclusion criteria include patients allergic to contrast, pregnant women, patients in end-stage renal and hepatic failure, elderly debilitated patients. Coming to the results and analysis, this is a table showing the distribution of the subjects. Most of the patients are seen in 45 to 60 years of age group. Coming to the distribution of subjects according to sex, 39 patients are male and 11 patients are female. Coming to the symptoms of distribution of subjects, most of the patients having cough as symptoms, 80%, followed by dyspnea, 76% of patients. Coming to the CT finding distribution in subjects, well-defined margins are seen in 68% of patients, conglomeration absent in 74% of patients, calcification is absent in 86% of patients, necrosis absent in 58% of patients, encasement and mass effect absent in 66%, contrast enhancement, homogeneous contrast enhancement seen in 30% of patients, heterogeneous enhancement seen in 14%, association between features of CT between benign and malignant lesions. Most of the management regions, 23% are having ill-defined margins. Conglomeration is absent in 62% of malignant lesions and absent in 94% of benign lesions. Necrosis is absent in 89% of benign and 38% of malignant lesions. Encasement and mass effect is absent in 90%, 52% of benign lesions, present in 11% and 49% of malignant lesions. Contrast enhancement is present in 42% of malignant lesions, homogeneous enhancement. Coming to extranodal site involvement, most common site of extranodal site involvement is lung, seen in 66% of patients. Coming to the clinical distribution, clinical diagnostic distribution, 34% of patients having tuberculosis as clinical diagnosis, and followed by lung carcinoma seen in 26% of patients. Coming to the radiological diagnosis distribution, most of the patients, 36% are having adenopathy with carcinoma lung, followed by lymphoma, 14% of patients. Coming to the histopathologic diagnostic distribution, 16% of the patients having non-small cell carcinoma and 16% having tuberculosis. Coming to the radiological classification distribution, malignant lesions, according to radiological classification, malignant lesions seen in 54% and benign lesions seen in 46% of patients. Coming to the histopathologic classification, malignant seen in 62% of patients, benign lesions seen in 38% of patients. And this is the CT image of metastatic lymph nodes seen in carcinoma esophagus patients. This is axial CT image showing enlarged necrotic lymph nodes seen in lymphoma patient. This is the axial CT thorax image showing necrotic enlarged lymph nodes with peripheral enhancement seen in squamous cell carcinoma patient. This is the calcified CT, axial CT image showing calcified lymph nodes in tuberculous lymphadenopathy patient. This is the calcified lymph nodes seen in axial CT image seen in sarcoidosis patient. There is showing peripheral axial calcification. Coming to the discussion, MDCT plays a vital role in characterization of mediastinal and hilar lymphadenopathy in benign, as benign and malignant etiologies. In our study, maximum number of cases was observed in male patients in 4th to 6th decade. In 50 patients, 31 patients had malignant lymphadenopathy, 19 patients are having benign etiology. In totally 50 cases were correlated with histopathology. The sensitivity of the test is 87%, specificity is 100%, positive predictive value is 100%, negative predictive value is 83%. Out of 31 subjects with malignant lesions, HPE, 88% were picked up by CT scan and 13% were false negative. Out of 19 subjects with benign lesions, HPE, 100% were benign in CT. Coming to the conclusion, there was a significant association between MDCT features and histopathology diagnosis of lymph nodes with respect to benign and malignant mediastinal and hilar lymphadenopathy, which showed the importance of CT in diagnosing the cause of the mediastinal and hilar lymphadenopathy. It also showed how MDCT plays important additional role in differentiating between the benign and malignant lymphadenopathy, showing the need to introduce its using routine practice. MDCT is an excellent and safe non-invasive method, giving all the information required for further management and management of the condition. This is the slide showing references. Thank you.